So if you look at the documentation, these are the prerequisites for remote desktop. We need to have softwares like Genome Desktop for providing UI, which we have already done. Then we need to have some server process. It is called as VNC server process, running for user on the host to maintain remote desktop connection between client and the host. So whatever user you are trying to connect, under that user, you need to have VNC server process. So in your case, if you want to connect to training should have a VNC server process running for him, and he will have a dedicated port for it. And he can have multiple ports like that so that multiple users can do the remote login at the same time. Okay. Tiger VNC server is one such software which can provide capability to run separate daemon process for each user who want to connect to GUI. So with Genome Desktop, you only get the components that are required for graphical user interface. To facilitate the connection and maintaining the connection between the client and the desktop based on Genome, you need to have a server process, and that is nothing but Tiger VNC server. There are several others, but Tiger VNC is one of the popular one. Each process for each user and host has to run on different port. I have explained it already, and we have to open that port in firewall so that people can establish connections using that port number. Also on the client, which is your PC, you have to set up VNC Viewer, which is very straightforward. You can also use Chrome extension as I have explained earlier. Okay. Now, if the server is rebooted, so it is not yet rebooted. I can ping that server. I can try pinging that server. It is not yet re yeah, now it is rebooted. So now I can connect. Okay, now I am inside the server. And if you see now, that error related to locale is not coming because I have updated etc environment file with those two lines. Okay, and now it is time to install Tiger VNC server. Okay, and this server you have to install as root, and you have to configure for each and every user connection for the remote desktop. And we will follow those steps once the installation is done. The installation is done successfully. Now what you have to do is you have to take an existing sample configuration file which works as template. We can open it up before actually copying and see what it has. Okay, you can see the details about all the different properties to establish a connection. More importantly, if you go to the end, there are certain settings which you need to take care. One is where the process ID should be stored that supports remote desktop for this user. So this is the location, and we have to replace this user with whatever user for which we are trying to set up the remote desktop. So first, what we have to do, we have to copy this into a etc systemd. So this is just a template. Whatever we have seen is template. We have to copy, and while copying, you need to make sure that you do not copy with this name. You have to add colon and one between VNC server yet and dot service, and this actually determines the port number on which the service will be running. So this is very, very important step which you need to keep in mind. Okay. It can start from one, and it can go to quite big number, 3 digit or 4 digit number. So you can have as many connections as the server can support, like couple of hundred for sure. Okay. So for each one, you have to increment this number, and you have to copy the file. You have to be a bit careful while copying this one. Okay. So now I'm copying this, and then I have to open this. And I want to configure this for my user called training. So wherever the user is mentioned, I want to replace it with training. So I can say percentage yes user training G. Okay. So it replaced wherever user is mentioned in angular brackets with the user using which I want to connect. And then I can say come out of this. Okay. Once this is done, You can also use sed to replace. So I have done manually. If you want, you can run this command, but make sure the file name is correct. Now you have to reload all the daemons using systemctl. Systemctl is a command in Linux which will manage the system services. Okay, so as we have added a new service to it, we have to reload. Okay, and then we have to enable a new service which we have just configured. So this service will be started whenever the server is rebooted. You don't need to start manually. If you don't enable this, once the server is rebooted, you might not be able to establish the remote desktop connection if the server is not up, and hence it's better to enable. Okay, once that is done, now you have to open the port number in firewall so that people from external world can connect to this. So in this case, if you look at the port number, I am specifying 5901. The reason why I have to specify 5901 is the VNC server port by default is 5900, and whatever number you add here while defining the server process for a user, that number has to be added to 5900. Okay, so in this case, as I am configuring for 1, I have to say 5901. If it is 100, I have to say 6000. Okay, so you just have to add the number which is plugged into that VNC server at and service to 5900 to open up the port. Okay, so there is a relationship between this and this. This number has to be added to 5900. I think if you look at the somewhere there might have the, it might have that 5900 as a beginning number. No, actually it's actually documented here. You can see here 590n. So this n has to be added. Okay, if it is 100, it has to be 6000. Somewhere I think you can configure this the base number. It can be different number also, but by default it's 5900. Okay, as the firewall, as the port number is opened in the firewall, now we have to reload the firewall. Okay, once this is done, we have to connect to the user under which I want to configure the VNC server and run the command called VNC server. When you run it for the first time, it will prompt you for the password, and this is the password which you should use from your client to connect to the server. Okay, so I am giving a password. You can say n here. I don't know what is the purpose of that. Okay, so it will create a bunch of directories. It will create a directory called .vnc. And there will be a bunch of files depending upon the configurations that are defined as part of that properties file which we have updated by replacing the user with training. Okay, based upon certain settings, it will create certain files to support the connectivity between the client and the server. Now you can exit and you can just reload the daemons again, and you can restart the service. Now you have a server process for your user training to establish and maintain the remote connection from the client to the server using the user training. You can go to VNC now. Let me delete this, which I already have. Let me also delete this. Okay, now I can say file, new connection, demo.itversity.com, and port number is 5901. So whatever is the port number that is being used for this user to maintain the connection, we have to give that port number. Click on OK, and then you can double click on this, and then it will prompt for the password. Okay, and then you have to enter the password which you have given for VNC server. This is different from the password which I have set up earlier when I created training user. Okay, so the user which I have used to SSH, or the password which I have configured for SSH, is different from the password which I have configured for VNC. Okay, So now you can say remember password so that you don't need to type again and again. Okay, and you have the remote desktop available for you. Okay, so this is the browser Chrome. I have closed it, and I can say applications, open Firefox, and I can use the browser. Okay, so there is some issue with respect to resolution, I guess. What I'm supposed to do is, let me close this and let me delete this. Okay, and let me add it once again. I think there is a setting which I have to take care while creating. So it is nothing but demo.itversity.com port number 5901. Okay, and then go to options, picture quality instead of automatic, let me say high, and then accept export. I think this is the one which I have to take care, and scaling, let me leave it to automatic, and then say okay, and then let me double click, and then let me enter the password. Okay, still, yeah, now it is better. You can see here I have closed the tabs. Yeah, now the UI is a bit better. Okay, now I can say applications and Firefox. If you specify high quality, then the performance might be a bit lower, but it will be much better when it comes to experience. And you can browse internet and all those things using this remote desktop. Okay, if you want to use terminal, you can go to applications. So typically we use either browser or terminal, sometimes from the desktop. You can actually open terminal from here and you can take certain actions from there. Okay, for some reason terminal is not coming up. I think I might have to reboot the machine. Once I reboot, it might work. Okay, so I will try to reboot and I will see. And we'll come back to this at a later point in time if it is required. But it is very nice to have when you learn or when you try to learn new technologies to have a remote desktop like this to quickly review something using graphical user interface if it is required. Okay, and that's why I have covered to set this up. As we are done with the remote desktop setup, now we will take further steps and install whatever is required depending upon our requirements in future.